in over your head. You may view this variety of errors in many ways, but the bottom line is, you're in over your head if you can't make the turn with one steering input. Why? One steering movement is the ideal scene for the bike. Look over some GP videotapes and see how many times Eddie Lawson or Wayne Rainey change lane angle in a turn. Doug says, it's one of the hardest things to feel at ease with. Everything is easier than understanding front-end contact and having it stay underneath you. As rules go, there are always exceptions, and this one follows suit. I don't think there is anyone who gets it right all the time. Small steering changes in mid-turn are nothing to be ashamed of. Loss of traction and bumps that throw the bike off an intended line will be corrected for by the best of riders. Please realize, though, that these corrections may not even be noticed by the guy directly behind because they are very slight, very subtle, and not quick or jerky. Realize also that 90% of these corrections are unnecessary, that they are truly SRs to your current situation. Most riders can figure out that their throttle control errors weren't needed, that they could have left the throttle on instead of going off on. Likewise, mid-turn steering fix-up jobs are just doing extra work. We've proven it over and over at the Superbike School. With an on-bike video camera looking over the rider's shoulder, we've been able to identify up to 5 steering changes per turn, none of them needed. The original steering input would have had the rider wind up in the same place. Set it and forget it. The basic rule here is, get the steering done with one positive motion and don't put any more attention on it. There are a number of things more interesting and more important once you're leaned over in a turn. The fewer steering changes per turn, the better. One steering action per turn is perfect. Donnie Green. Mid-turn on-offs and readjusting lean angle come from not knowing the limits of your steering, either too slow or too fast. You should experiment with quick and slow steering just to get a good feel for the range you can work with. With school students, you can see when they get it right for the first time, not stiff. I know exactly when I'm in over my head. That's when I'm using my knee to keep it from crashing. Steering. Chapter 15. Lazy turns and the turn scale. You spend some amount of time turning or steering your bike, going from straight up to leaned over, at every corner. How much time and attention does it cost you to perform this very important task? Have you ever noticed how quickly the top guys can do it? Is this just because they have superior equipment? Doug, there are fearless guys who can just get through a section quick, steering, but don't know why, and they crash. If how quickly you can turn or steer your bike were on a scale from 1 to 10, where would you be? If we call this your steer rate, and Eddie Lawson, Wayne Rainey, or Doug Chandler are at 10, where are you? With as much as a 2-second steer rate being readily observable in most street riders, Eddie, Doug, or Wayne can do it in a half a second, I place the average rider at about 3 or 4 on the scale. What does it take to move up the scale, and why would you want to? What prevents you from steering the bike more quickly? Steering SRs. Let's face it, steering a motorcycle quickly is scary. You fear it might go out from under you. Traction at a quickly achieved, leaned-over position can be doubtful. And, along with the steering process comes lean angle, one of the more classic SR triggers. New riders are generally not interested in overwhelming themselves with either turning too quickly or steep lean angles. The lean angle credit card. Oddly enough, even though they resist it, street riders in tense cornering situations always use far too much lean angle for their speed. So do most racers. This is the lean angle credit card. Whether affordable, may safely lean over further, or not, the frame, pipe, bodywork, or etc. is already dragging on the ground, they crank it over some more. I have repeatedly observed riders dragging parts when a rider who understood steering and lean could go through the same turn on the same bike, 5 or 10 miles per hour faster, and still have leaned over ground clearance to spare. Is it better to be at steeper lean angles? Would you prefer to be leaned over less and still go as fast? Chandler. You don't use a flat deck lean angle very often.